Welcome to another episode of That Very Tragic Story, or in this case, Horror in the Metropolis. This week we were looking again at one of the many human interest stories that occurred during the attack on New York in 1953 by the Redosaurus. The subject of today's episode is the death of Police Corporal Sinclair Hartwise, who needlessly gave his life in the name of Municipal Chivalry. In the early afternoon of the 30th of March 1953, Manhattan dock workers were relaxed during their lunch hour, unaware that lurking somewhere very nearby, just beneath the ocean surface, lay the Redosaurus. As the creature drifted ashore, they fled in panic, prowling through the streets, leaving behind it a trail of carnage. The police were alerted into action pretty soon.
Coming up Nassau Street toward Pine. Get some help, fast!
However, at this moment, while patrolling National Street, our foolhardy protagonist stealthily approached the beast, thus discharging his revolver. Here again we see this tragic moment as it unfolded. So, what motivated Hartwise to shoot an armor-plated dinosaur the size of Westminster Abbey? What led this seemingly mild-mannered corporal to needlessly throw away his life in what seemed like a futile gesture? Was this merely some misguided attempt to preserve order? Or were there deep psychological reasons for his actions? To throw light on this matter, we need to delve into his life. Who was this fellow? Who was Hartwise? Sinclair Hartwise had a very tragic start in life. He was one of one sibling who brought up by the doting parents who were rich and provided him with a first-class education. In his worldly riches he knew nothing but famine, and in his joy nothing but despair. A man battle-hardened by the harrows of easy living, he remained unspoilt by the suffering and hardship that typified many members of the urban poor, who he quietly envied for their poverty. Confident in his innate superiority over all other human beings, he had a high ambition to become Commissioner of Police, so much so that he joined the New York Police in 1938. And he was not popular amongst his fellow officers. Being so sure of his innate superiority, and yet a man of tiny physical frailties, he was often bullied by his co-workers, who saw him as a self-inflated little fruit fly. One important episode that led to further derision and alienation from his fellow officers was that one fateful day of April 1947, where he attempted to subdue a feral goose and failed. His confidence in his ability to discharge his duties was shaken when, after hours of wrestling with the goose, he was finally overpowered. Mockingly, his fellow officers watched as he attempted to subdue the marauding creature, which turned into an immortal battle for supremacy. And after a Herculean struggle between man and beast, Grosvenor was forced to capitulate. This episode marked the beginnings of a nervous breakdown. A breakdown that would culminate in the fateful events of March 1953. This is certainly the theory advocated by the eminent psychiatrist Dr. Matthew Drinkwater.
You see, it was the grandiosity that characterized his view of himself compared to other people. People he saw as blessed by hardship. In combination with inability to subdue some of God's tiniest creatures, including that of a plump goose that led him down this path of self-destruction.
From here, he sought at every opportunity to prove that he was not only master of himself, but also marauding poultry. All to no avail. One day, having been demolished by an earthworm, which I may add was adopted by the Grosvenor family, whereupon it became a family heirloom, upon this final humiliation he finally cracked. But somberly patrolling National Street, he encountered the Redosaurus and saw his chance for redemption. And well, you know the rest. Here are just some outtakes of excerpts that just didn't make it into the documentary because they were so awful. Here are some of Hartnett Grosvenor's chilling last words before his untimely demise. This planet is yours! Quiet! Cut! Who let him here? Don't let him in here, get him out! Your destiny is to end up forever shackled and imprisoned amongst the right bosom of a fat woman, Arthur. Quiet, we're still recording. I'm sorry. You're a fruitless MacArthur. Get out!